everybody, and welcome back again to another drum playthrough review. So thanks for tuning in and stopping by, and for everybody who is brand new, hello and welcome. My name is Nick. We play drums, guitar, bass, and a whole bunch of other instruments, and we watch these videos because it's great for us to learn from drummers who are better than us, so that way we can glean their technique, apply it ourselves into our daily routines, and ultimately become better musicians. So today we're going to be reviewing a drummer who is absolutely insane and phenomenal. He plays for the band known as Animals as Leaders, which is a fantastic band that comes from the state of Maryland, the Washington, D.C. specifically. Anyhow, his name is Mike Garska. He's actually a drummer that's from my home state here, Virginia. So this man is an absolute insane beast when it comes to polyrhythms. He's got a lot of chops. He's definitely taken into effect a lot of different styles and a lot of different ways of playing, and he's utilized that to his benefit, embracing everything that he can from each one of those styles, all the different grooves, slaves, and it's helped to craft his style in particular to make him the drummer that he is. And of such legendary status. So what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and take a look at Monomyth, which is a playthrough song that he did for Animals as Leaders. And this is off of Sumerian Records' official page. So hopefully they won't copyright strike me out of oblivion like certain other record labels do. We're still in dispute with that one, so hopefully they'll actually let me air that video eventually. All right. Without further ado, ladies and gents, let us get into it. Monomyth. Already starting out with a time signature. No triggers, no edits, 100% live drums. That's the way I like it, man. I will eventually have to trigger out my bass drums, but... Oh my god, dude. Dude, look at his forearms. He's got ripples going up them forearms, bro. That's insane. So already we can tell he's keeping things very loose. He's using a lot of finger technique, wrists when it comes to certain parts on the hi-hat. Especially on the accents. See, parts like that, that's all fingers, right? Very good with his accents. Heels up player, obviously. He's using angle technique. Common, I use angle technique. But he does something a little bit different. He actually lets his feet come off of the pedals. Which you don't see a lot of drummers do. That's kind of interesting for a technique. I don't even know what time signature this is in. Really? Oh yeah, here we go. So now we get into these chops here. You know what's crazy is that, believe it or not, a lot of these chops that are done that you see are insanely fast. These, a lot of them are based off of paradiddles, or variations of the paradiddle. We're just led to believe it's something insanely different because of how fast it is, and because it's split up between two different drums. But I guarantee you, if you break down the drum literature and all that, if you break down the sheet music and all that, it's probably based off of a paradiddle or a paradiddle variation. See, like right there is based off the triple pattern, that riff there. Kind of like a waltz a little bit. Wow, that was a good fill. Right here he's using an experimental pattern. That's not traditional like metal patterns or anything like that. That's like that's gotta be either Latin or African. It's one of those two by the sounds of it. See, right here we've got a metric modulation part that he switched up the feeling of because of the ghost notes. That's how important ghost notes are in a song. What a phenomenal drummer, dude. This guy can play. Damn, son. Wow. Oh, he's got full transcriptions available online. Nice. I might have to purchase that, honestly, and take a look at it. But again, what a phenomenal drummer Matt Garska is. That man has taken time to master his instrument, and in one of the most insane ways possible. He's come out with an insane combination of styles that has become ultimately his style, and that's what makes him him. So here's a couple things that we can learn from this guy. So for one, polyrhythms. My God, dude, that is some insane polyrhythms. Obviously, he's using a lot of different polyrhythms, metric modulation, etc., etc., in that particular song. You can tell, too, that his technique, he's keeping everything very loose. But something that is good to note, he's switching up his techniques right there, middle of the song, really quickly as well. You'll see he's using parts of where he's using wrist motion and all that on the hi-hat. And then when it comes to the faster parts, he switches and starts using fingers instead. This is good. This shows you that with practice, you can seamlessly transition between techniques to accomplish the speeds that you're trying to accomplish. See, a lot of drummers will get stuck in one particular technique. Like, they'll want to solely just do wrist if they're doing wrist motion for God knows how long in the song. Or they'll want to stick with fingers because they've been doing finger motion for God knows how long in the song. And a good way, honestly, to break that up and to help to keep things fresh and also help to less sterilize your playing and more keep things available for new opportunities so that way you can change speeds and make things a whole lot faster is you practice transitioning between larger muscle groups to smaller muscle groups in a very short amount of time. So for him, like I said, you'll see he was using wrist motion on the hi-hat and all that, then very quickly switching to fingers instead. Practicing that, starting out slow, that will help you eventually when you're going into faster tempos and whatnot. If you're playing something that's a little bit more of a wrist beat and then you have to switch very quickly to fingers, that really does help with the transition, so that way there's a lot less mess-ups during your playing. Something else that we do need to talk about as well regarding his technique and all that is feel. You'll notice when he was playing that one part of the song that switched up using a metric modulation, the ghost notes changed how everything felt in the entire song. Ghost notes are extremely important, very important, especially in your playing. Misplacing a couple of ghost notes here and there is actually going to change the entire feel of your song. And that is something that I think a lot of drummers don't take into effect, especially. A lot of people nowadays, they want to see all these people doing ghost notes and all that. So they start throwing ghost notes in willy-nilly, especially a lot of newer drummers who don't exactly know how to use them. But if you really break down how the ghost notes are placed, a lot of it is based off of rudiment patterns. So for example, like I mentioned earlier, a lot of these fast chops and all that that are split up between multiple drums, like your snare and your hi-hat and your ride cymbal or whatnot, a lot of the times that's just a paradiddle or a paradiddle variation that's been split apart between two drums, and it's just played in insanely fast speeds. And a lot of times people don't even notice it because of how quickly it's done. Drilling rudiments to help with your chops and help you learn how to place ghost notes in a song to change up the feel are extremely vital. This is why I urge any new drummer, get into music theory, start thinking about learning music theory, start investigating the basics of it, start getting a base knowledge, and try and learn as much as you can from music theory. It's absolutely essential. It really does help your playing. Because regardless of what you'll hear other people say, oh, you don't need metal, music theory in metal, whatnot, blah, blah, blah. It's all a lie. Especially if you want to start playing more complicated rhythms and whatnot that are more fun. And I'm being honest, it is a whole lot more fun. You don't want to stick to just like a skank beat, a 2-4 beat, or, a blast beat the whole time for your playing. That's just going to sound absolutely stale. And you don't want to just keep doing the, fills. You don't want to just do single stroke fills the whole time. I mean, that's just going to get really bland after a while. You can only come up with so many combinations of that before you start to sound like everybody else. But if you really want to stand out, drill your rudiments, learn your music theory, all of that is absolutely vital. Another thing that has really helped Mount Garska is experimenting with other styles. This man has practiced jazz, samba, and a whole bunch of other different styles, so that way he can liven up his playing, make it sound fresh like it's a brand new perspective, and bring a whole lot more life into his progressive band. So that way it keeps things fresh, it keeps things unique, and also it gives things a little bit of a different sound, because there's not a whole lot of metal drummers that are bringing samba into their playing, or samba claves or anything like that. Like, you'll hear people who will bring a Latin bell clave into something every so often, but like, you won't see a whole lot of other styles other than that. But it is absolutely phenomenal. There's a whole lot of different styles that are out there drumming-wise that you can honestly learn from, and apply that to your metal drumming as well. For example, bossa nova. How many people do you know actually apply bossa nova into their metal playing? I'm guessing the number is probably zero, because there's like zero people nowadays that really like playing bossa nova. Think about possibly breaking away from metal for a little while and trying another style that's a little bit out of your comfort zone. Whether that be jazz, samba, Latin music or whatnot, bossa nova even, if you want to really go out that far. Start experimenting with other styles. Start taking and pulling technique from all these other places and start learning different rudiments from other places and see what you can learn from these guys. See how you can apply that to your metal playing and see how awesome it's going to sound, especially when you start adding that into stuff. And with all that being said, guys, we're going to cut that video here. So here's a few things y'all can do to support me. So for one, you can check out the playlists that I got down below that are very similar to this video. You can like, share, comment, subscribe. You can also check out the links that I got down below to my Spotify page and my band page. That would really help me out. And with all that being said, guys, that's the end of this video. So hopefully you guys enjoyed it. Thanks for sticking around for the end. Thanks for stopping by. And hopefully I will see y'all in the next video. So cheers, everybody, and have a good night.